Today we will study how to measure the flux and formula for that, electric flux. This is a charge, it is creating electric field all around it, and these lines represent direction of electric field and the distance are different. So electric field magnitude at all these points are different, the direction is different. Now this dark line you see, this line, this represents a surface. See, from this point up to this point, it is a surface, and this electric field is getting linked. You remember the word link. This electric field is linked with this. We want to calculate how much is the flux which is linked with this area. For that, our formula will be, see here, our formula will be like this. At different places, we draw a very small areas. Here, this is the area. Then, where is the area vector? Answer, perpendicular to it. This is area vector. I will call it unit vector area. Now, this is electric field. E. The angle between electric field and area vector is at this place theta. Then the flux linked to this very small area dA, this is to be multiplied with value of E here, and this gives me a very small flux at this place. If I write this flux by a notation phi and make it phi e, electric flux, because later we are going to study magnetic flux also. So this is phi e. This phi e is equal to electric field here multiplied by this very small area dA. And if I see the magnitude, this is e dA cos theta. This is the formula we saw from the previous lecture. There I did not tell you about the flux symbol. Remember, the symbol of flux is phi. Okay, phi e is e dA cos theta at this location. Similarly, at this location, everywhere we see that here I take a small area. This is area vector perpendicular to it. And here the value of theta has changed. Here it was on negative side, or this is on positive side. Here it is on negative side, and the value is different. So at this place flux will be different, and that flux will be, the other value of flux will be E at this location dA and cos theta. This theta 1, theta 2. This is E1, this is value here E2. So in this way, here the flux is phi 1, here the flux is phi 2. Similarly, we take the flux here, this is, we take the flux here. For all these small areas, we calculate d phi 1. D phi, small flux in the small area. Small flux in the small area. Then again, small flux d phi e3 is equal to e3. Here, this is theta 3, this value is e3, and this small area. This small area we can of course take similar. So this is dA and cos theta 3. In this way, we have taken small flux at all the places. And then what is the technique we adopt in calculus? That says the total phi will be summation of all these three. Now if it is summation of these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, many dAs, dA, 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 how many? Infinite. Why infinite? Because dA we have taken very small, that is tending towards 0, approaching 0. Such a small areas we take. So our phi calculations are correct. At every point we have taken separate phi and then we add up all in mathematics, that is we integrate all. If we have done very small areas, infinite areas, every area is approaching 0, then we have entered calculus and the total flux will be integration all d phi's. So that will be integration of d phi's. And what are these d phi integration? Those are e at every place, dA at every place into cos theta. So this is how we write electric flux formula for any shape of the area in any electric field. Variable electric field, variable areas, variable theta, everything is variable. Then we have no go, we have no other path than to integrate for each small area. So you will remember this formula, E dA cos theta is equal to phi A, integration of this. So this we are going to use very widely, and this is electric flux measurement for any area. This is the general formula. Okay, this general formula, if we apply for a uniform electric field and we have one area here, that area is also a plane area. So at every place, what is the area vector? Answer, this is the area vector. And this is the electric field vector. Electric field. And what is the value of theta? Both are parallel. So theta is equal to 0. For every place theta is equal to 0. Then flux will be how much? Flux is equal to integration of E dA cos 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1. Now this is a uniform electric field. Because this is a uniform electric field, it has the same value at every point. It can be treated as a constant, and a constant comes out of the integration. Now it is integration of dA, and here dA, add up all the dA, what will we get? Area. So this is E into A, this is flux, and this is our basic formula what we had done. So flux E into A, if regular surface, uniform electric field. If electric field is non-uniform and the surface is also irregular, then this formula. So this is for irregular surface and non-uniform E. This is uniform E and regular surface. Okay. So in the next lecture we will see what is meant by a closed surface, and if that closed surface is placed in a space which has got electric field, then how do we calculate electric flux linked with the closed surface? Thank you.